Describe a function g of x in terms of f of x if the graph of g of x is obtained by reflecting the graph of f of x about the x-axis and if it is horizontally stretched by a factor of 2 when compared to the graph of f of x. So because g of x is a transformation of f of x, we can express g of x in this form here, where the values of a, b, c, and d transform the graph of f of x. But for this example, since we have a reflection across the x-axis and a horizontal stretch, we're only concerned about the value of a, which affects the reflection across the x-axis, and the value of b, which affects the horizontal stretch. Which means our function g of x will be in the form of g of x equals a times f of bx. So let's review some notes on reflections and horizontal stretches and compressions, and then we'll also verify our work looking at an animation. The graph of g of x equals negative f of x is the graph of f of x reflected across the x-axis, which is what's happening in our case. Looking at this equation, notice how if we change the sign of f of x, we're changing the sign of the y-coordinates of the function, and therefore the graph is reflected across the x-axis. So for our problem, a is equal to negative 1. The graph of g of x equals f of negative x is the graph of f of x reflected across the y-axis. Notice here we're changing the sign of the x-coordinates of the inputs, which reflects the graph across the y-axis. And now for the horizontal stretches and compressions, assuming d is greater than 1, the graph of g of x equals f of 1 over d times x is the graph of f of x stretched horizontally by a factor of d. So in our case, our graph is stretched horizontally by a factor of 2. The reciprocal of 2 is 1/2, so 1/2 is our coefficient here, or the value of b. The graph of g of x equals f of dx is the graph of f of x compressed horizontally by a factor of 1 over d. So for example, if we had f of 2x here, the graph would be compressed horizontally by a factor of 1/2. But in our case, we already know we have a horizontal stretch by a factor of 2, so b is equal to 1/2. So the value of a is equal to negative 1 because of the reflection across the x-axis, and the value of b is equal to 1/2 because we have a horizontal stretch by a factor of 2. So our function g of x is equal to negative f of 1/2 x. Now to verify this, I think it's helpful to take a look at a basic function and see if when a is negative 1 and b is 1/2, the graph is reflected across the x-axis and stretched horizontally by a factor of 2. Let's first change a to negative 1. So we'd have f of x equals negative x squared. Here it is, and notice how this is a reflection across the x-axis. And now we'll change the value of b to 1/2 to see if this horizontally stretches this graph. Notice as soon as b is less than 1, it does start to stretch horizontally. And here's b equals 1/2 or 0.5, and it has stretched the graph horizontally by a factor of 2. So this verifies that our answer is correct. I hope this was helpful.